This video is a very short review of a brand new film about perfumery called Nose. Shout out to one of my subscribers for recommending this to me. I'm gonna let all of you guys know if I think this film's worth watching or not. Okay, so this film is a documentary and it follows perfumer François Demanchy, who is the main perfumer at Dior, the famous fragrance brand. A lot of the film is centered around Grasse, which is a small town in the south of France, right on the border to Italy. This is where François grew up and spent most of his life, and it also happens to be the world capital of perfumery. This film has a really big focus on the raw materials used in perfumery. We get to go around the world to various countries like Indonesia, where they find patchouli, or Ireland, where they collect ambergris from the shorelines. Not only does this give the film a great chance to show off a variety of cinematic shots, but it also gives us a chance to have interviews with all of these people who collect and produce these raw materials and to really get to know what it's like. I think one of the highlights of the films is that we get to visit both Capua in Italy and Roberté in Grasse. These are two very highly regarded raw materials producers for perfumery, and if you're doing perfumery yourself, I think it's really important to understand the amount of expertise and know-how that goes into making these high quality materials at these top manufacturers. And this is why sometimes in perfumery you don't want to be cheaping out and buying cheap raw materials. You actually want to go and buy something from a trusted producer, because you're really going to get a great quality product. Again, companies like Dior, who are producing perfumes, would be using cheaper products if they could, but they can't, literally because they find that these products are the only things that can make their perfume smell as great as they do. Apart from the raw materials themselves, we do get some insights into the perfumery process and what it means to be a perfumer, what it means to do perfumery. We have some nice analogies scattered in the film between perfumery and music, which is, I think, very nice if you are not very familiar with the ins and outs of composing a perfume. We also get a lot of thoughts from François himself scattered throughout the documentary. One thing that I think is really important to note is how in the film, we see that François practices learning his raw materials every single day. In one scene, we see him with his friend Jacques Cavalier, who is a perfumer for Louis Vuitton. And they are just sitting at a table together. They are trying to guess what's in the bottles and also have a discussion about the very minor nuances in each of the things that they smell. If you're studying perfumery yourself, I would really recommend that this is something you try to do if possible. Another thing that I do like is the fact that we see quite a few shots with François in his office making his perfumes. You really get an idea of what it's like in a professional perfumery office. And I think this is quite inspiring if you're at home on how you might want to lay out your ingredients and how you might want to set things up. One final point is that you really see how perfumers smell everything in their day-to-day lives. François smells iron from swordsmiths in Japan. He's distinguishing between wines at some kind of wine tasting event, and he's smelling everything else in between, like flowers at the markets, and he's smelling the soil where he goes. They really practice dissecting smells and raw materials every day. So if you want to be a perfumer, this is, again, something that you should really be kind of doing. One minor point, this film is mostly in French. So if you don't really speak French very well like me, then you're going to have subtitles on the whole time. So just make sure you're comfortable with that. You can get the film on Netflix, Apple TV, and Google Play. I picked it up on Google Play for £4.50, renting it for 2 days. The only problem I had was that it didn't actually allow you to watch in HD on the web player. So just in case, like me, you don't have a TV, then quick heads up. But yeah, overall, I think the film was pretty good for a film on perfumery, especially considering that there aren't really any good films on perfumery. So as an average viewer, I wouldn't say the film is particularly special, but if you are into perfumery and you're interested in perfumery, then I think this is a really great film to watch. I think the videography in particular and the range of shots were really good, though I do think that the composition could have been a little bit better because it was a little bit lacking in terms of a storyline, and also the kind of music choices didn't really fit, I thought. Anyway, overall, I still think the film was a good film. Finally, if you're interested in perfumery yourself or learning how to make your own perfumes from home, then definitely head over to my channel where I have lots of free videos showing you how to get started in perfumery as a complete beginner and start actually being able to create some things. Anyway, that's all from me, so thank you very much for watching and enjoy the rest of your day.